Hello, sport fans. It's another time out on Limitless Soccer Vlog today with Bayonle Arashi. It's been a while. Guys, I'm a bit under the weather, so I hope you guys accept my apologies for not coming your way over the weekend because I was a bit down and, you know, sometimes your body just needs a rest and you need to catch up on a very, 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 very rough week, which was last week. But here I am back today on the vlog. Last week, Saturday, it was so much fun at the BBVA Stadium where Houston Dynamo welcomed the Dallas FC from Dallas. Wow, it was a great, great, great game. And what happened? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 goals to nothing against FC Dallas in that particular one. I'm so impressed with the Houston Dynamo squad. 8 goals in 2 matches, 3 conceded in the first game against the New England Revolution. I think it's a very, very, very good time to be a Houston Dynamo fan. So, forever orange, go guys! And I wish you guys all the best for the season. You're not going to have any other home game until the first week in April. I think that will be on April 10th when they will welcome Seattle Sounders. And of course, the LA Galaxy will be up next at home at the BBVA Stadium. The Dynamo next 2 games will be away games at the first one will be against New York Red Bulls. That's going to be in New York. And of course, it's going to be Vancouver Whitecaps away also for the Houston Dynamo. But did you watch all those action in Europe over the weekend as well? Well, what a season we're going to say it is has been for Chelsea. Terrible season, no other word for it. Last week, they were out of UEFA Champions League after being defeated by Paris Saint-Germain 2-1 at home. Bad season it was on Saturday also. Was it Saturday or Sunday? It was Saturday. Saturday, Chelsea also were knocked out of the Emirates FA Cup by Everton, courtesy of Romelu Lukaku, former Chelsea striker, sold to Everton for a record fee of £18 million, scoring 2 quick goals in the second half to knock Chelsea FC out of the Emirates FA Cup. So, what a season it's been. Definitely, we see that the manager is not the problem for Chelsea. Some of the players need to take up responsibility now. The management need to do something very, very quick about some of the players in that squad and make the needed changes as fast as they can. It's not been a good season to be a Chelsea fan, but what do? We got to move on and, of course, talk about the game. Also, last week, I didn't come your way on Thursday because there were so many games. I remember the Europa League fixture between Tottenham Hotspur against Borussia Dortmund in Germany. Well, I'm sure it's a game to forget for the Spurs because they were totally beaten 3-0 by Dortmund, courtesy of African Player of the Year, Pierre-Emerick Aubameyang, scoring some good goals in that particular one, and with Marco Reus also scoring in that particular one, sending Tottenham Hotspur to putting them in a very tight corner against the return leg this week in that particular one in the Europa League. Also yesterday in the La Liga, did you see that game between Real Madrid and Las Palmas? Though I didn't join the game until about the 77th minute, but of course, thank God I did not miss that. 2 quick goals towards the end of the game. The red card for Sergio Ramos, a stupid one I'm going to call it, but he got a red card in that one and was sent off. But the team still came back from that equalizer by Las Palmas towards the end of the game to win the goal. 2 set-piece goal by Real Madrid in that one. Sergio Ramos got a goal and also got sent off before the midfielder Casemiro scored the winning goal for Real Madrid and coach Zinedine Zidane. Well, the Champions League will be back this week with a visit of Arsenal. Arsenal, what do we say about them? Also, over the weekend, they were knocked out of the Emirates FA Cup by who else but Watford Football Club. Nigeria's Ojoni Gallo broke his goal drought by scoring first in that particular one, turning Gabriel in the 18-yard box and scoring a very good goal to give Watford a 1-0 victory before that very fierce shot by the Watford player to give them a 2-0 lead before Welbeck scored a solitary goal for Arsenal. But it was not enough as the champions of Emirates FA Cup were knocked out. So it's between all these little boys now to see who's going to win. Everton is still there. Watford is there. West Ham and Manchester United had to share a 1-1 draw. Of course, that one was a replay was forced by Manchester United, courtesy of Antonio Martial goal for Manchester United. So a replay in that particular one. So we'll see how it goes. But Watford and Everton are already in the semi-finals of the FA Cup. But what do you think is going to happen at the Camp Nou this week between between Arsenal and Barcelona? Well, Barcelona with that strong lead at home, away at Camp Nou about 2 weeks ago. Well, we'll see what happens within the week. And of course, Dortmund is coming to town also. They're coming to London with that return leg in the of the Europa League between Dortmund and Tottenham Hotspur. Guys, what was your game of the week? What was your high point of the week? What do you think made your weekend a very good one? The weekend was good for me because I saw a home game in the MLS, and of course I saw some great games as well. Though Chelsea, the other team I supported, apart from Houston Dynamo, did not make the weekend so good. But what is your own high point? Drop the comment below, and of course follow me on all my social media platforms: Facebook, my name Bayonle Arashi, on Twitter at Maida Soccer, on Instagram at Maida Soccer. Let's get the discussion going. I will do my best to come your way before the week runs out. After the UEFA Champions League return leg games, Juventus against Bayern Munich is also going to be this week. Tough games in the Champions League and the Europa League. And today it's going to be Leicester City against Newcastle in the English Premier League. The only English Premier League game that was played yesterday was between Aston Villa and Tottenham Hotspur, but Spurs won that one by 2-0, courtesy of Harry Kane brace in that particular one. But guys, let me know your thoughts. What has been the high point of the week for you in the world of the beautiful game? My name is Bayonle Arashi. Till I see you guys again, have a great week, be awesome, and always be yourself. Bye for now. God bless you. Love you guys. Bye.